So hi there again today. So today I'm going to talk to you about illustrations from a science fiction book that really influenced me. First of all, I'm just going to quickly show you some components that I've been doing for a 3D print. Is it going to autofocus? No, I'll take that off. So these are things that are going to stack up on a kind of truck, a four-wheel drive off-road truck for my science fiction universe I'm making. Here's a wheel as well. So that outside, if you can see that, that was where the supports are. So it was down like that. So that's why it's quite rough. So I'm kind of sanding it off. But the rough on the outside of the wheel sometimes looks quite good as well. The inside, that's where an axle is going to go. So I'll just get an axle. So the axle goes in like that. Voila. And that's right. So, and if you're interested and you don't know what I'm doing, is you can check out my blog. Get an autofocus again. Sorry. Annoying. Right. So it's the 3Z universe set on Earth in the near future. The 3Z science fiction universe witnessed its expansion every week with new fantastic artworks. And it's my website, jamesabelart.com blog. So I'm really, really wrapped up in doing that at the moment. And in 2 months, there'll be an actual really cool, funky product that comes out of it. So be sure to follow me or sign up on my newsletter or sign up on YouTube to stay notified when that comes out. So what I'm going to talk to you today is about is a book called Dangerous Visions by Harlan Ellison. And this book's really old. Well, this version, which at the time it was classic, is Galanksk. Sorry, I never pronounced that properly. Galanksk classic sci-fi. And I got this when I was about 15. So that was in 1991 or 2. So even then it was a classic book. So I think it came out in 1970, and it's like sort of new wave American science fiction writers that were kind of avant-garde, you know, think about people like Philip K. Dick, you know. So they weren't really writing about, you know, Johnny Ranger going to Jupiter anymore. They were writing about really interesting sort of issues and psychological things and that sort of thing, using science fiction as a vehicle to look at that, which is what good science fiction should be. And as you can see on the cover, they've got some really nice illustrations, and this shows you all the illustrations for each story. I think the colors were put in, you know, on the jacket for this version. And I'm looking at the back here, and it says £6.95. So for a book this big, that's not a bad price these days. So we can notice the evolution of inflation from just looking at a price of a book from that time ago. So the original illustrations were by Leo and Diane Dillon. And I did some background research, and I think they were contemporary illustrators, but they didn't concentrate on science fiction, which is a really good thing. Because with science fiction then and science fiction these days, you get a lot of kind of slick, polished, science fiction-y backgrounds, often imitating things like Blade Runner, that sort of thing, and I can go on about this all day. In movie effects as well, it's very slick, but I don't think it has so much soul in it as some of these illustrations. And the reason why these illustrations are effective is because they are completely black and white, and I think they are wooden block prints. Yeah, so they're very striking. So look at this one, and the titles of the story in Dangerous Visions are so good. This one's called "Go Go Go," Said the Bird. And I just think it's great. I mean, it might not be your cup of tea, these illustrations, but I think the black and white simplistic ones really burn into your heads, into your memory. This one especially, this is called "Gonna Roll the Bones," and you know, just look at that image, without even looking at the story, it just makes you think of so many different things. Just find one more image for the roads. So this one, Ersatz. So I can't remember what the story's about, but it's got a Santa Claus, and I think it's some sort of, is it a German soldier? So there you go. So really big book that influences me, and as you know, my 3Z universe is kind of a retro-y kind of universe, so I'll just show you the card again for any of you that haven't seen it before. And it's an interesting story as well, because it originated in when I was in Iceland last year, and I'm expanding it as well now. And it's not focusing. Oh man, there you go. So it's, and again, it's jamesabelart.com blog. So be sure to subscribe to that. So let me know what you think of this book, and if you like this kind of me looking into my influences, because I'm not really doing many tutorials at the moment because I'm concentrating wholly on my 3Z products. And as you can see, there's a nice, without knocking it and not looking back, there's a nice 3D print here that I've made. And this one is yellowy, but it didn't come out too well, so this is just using yellow paint. So I'm going to probably go into the model shop in Glasgow. There's one called Scott's Models, so I'll check that out. I think it was, he seems quite helpful on the phone, and I'll try and find some metallic paints and also some weathering. I think there's something, a Revell weathering kit as well. So getting into model making after all these years, having a break from it when I was a kid, and then now doing it now for my job. So thanks very much, and have a good one. And the sun's really shiny out here, so I'm going to go and enjoy the sun while it lasts here in the Glasgow area, because it often rains here, as you know if you visited it. So thanks very much, and bye for now. Have a good weekend.